was just lifted tonight. We speak a blessing upon the givers tonight. And we thank you and we honor you. In Jesus' mighty name, everybody shall say amen. Thank you so much. You may take your seats. Hallelujah. Just before quickly we come to the next item. Right. Yeah. Those of you that you want to avail yourself to the we have some products on sale at the back in the foyer there. The message that was preached in Kitwe under the title Shut In. Then there's The New Wind. And then there's a leadership also message that was done in Kitwe. Very powerful messages that when you listen to them, they will transform your life. Amen. And then there's a power of introduction. And then we have some t-shirts also on sale just in the foyer just after the service. Just visit the foyer there and get yourself some of these materials. Amen. Bless the Lord.
Statement
for the Zambia shall be saved. Zambia shall be saved is a statement of fact, not a proposal. It derives its energy from my faith in the unfailing power of the gospel. Today, we launch a movement of faith, an abiding belief that if God's people work together, evil as it has besieged us shall be defeated, and indeed Zambia shall be saved. This platform of the Zambia shall be saved senses belongs to God. It shall not peddle any political agenda which is not anchored in God's word. It shall seek to interpret the difficulty political, economic, and social questions facing Zambia through the scriptures. It shall seek to interpret the meaning of Zambia as a Christian nation. It shall seek to provide a prophetic platform and give direction for the country. It shall seek to become the general Christian platform for all of God's people in Zambia to express their confidence in God regardless of political, religious, tribal, and gender inclination. It shall be the fearless solution-oriented platform for all those who believe that Zambia's salvation is anchored in God's word. It shall mobilize resources to become the first responder to national disasters. And I want to conclude by saying, yes, indeed, Zambia shall be saved. This is the vision that God planted in his servant at the age of 17. That's when this vision was birthed in his heart. And we shall see this vision come to pass. As a matter of fact, Zambia shall be saved, and it is being saved. And this vision shall come to pass, and I've been praying and said, I want to see this vision come to pass in my time. And I believe in your time. So God bless you all as we together echo this message across this nation that Zambia
shall be saved. Everybody says Zambia shall be saved.
Zambia shall be saved.
At this particular time, I'm going to ask the choir. We're going to stand to our feet and we'll sing our theme song for Zambia shall be saved. Let's all stand to our feet. It says Zambia shall be saved song. We sang it last time. It's very powerful. So let's sing it prayerfully, believing in this vision that God has given to this man, that indeed Zambia shall be saved. God bless you all.
If you believe, and I believe, and we
and Anangwa, and they all got keys. Praise God. It's all right, I'll keep the keys. You lost the keys. I want you to see this lady here with a Mercedes-Benz key and the other one. I think it's a terrific key. Just see our chief usher there and collect your keys from her. At this particular time, I'm going to ask Reverend Ruben Sandor to come to the podium, please.